My name is Dr. Jean Eyre. I'm a consultant dermatologist and a honorary senior clinical lecturer at Salford Royal and University of Manchester. We did this study because the atrophic facial phenotype is a newly discovered and reported phenotype that has been recently published in the literature. It's of enormous clinical relevance to dermatologists, as it would appear that atrophic facial skin appears to have a higher predilection for the development of keratinocyte skin cancers. This study was important because, as this is a newly described phenotype, it was hugely important to us as a research team to provide a tool that would enable both clinical and non-clinical dermatologists to be able to easily recognise an atrophic phenotype. They have the advantage also of providing a consistent frame of reference by minimising variability in perception and subjectivity. Lastly, a photonumeric scale already exists for recognising the hypertrophic facial phenotype. The study was done over a period of 2 years where a number of the authors actually sat in dermatology outpatient clinics. They then identified atrophic individuals who were happy to consent to have their photographs taken and used in the study. From that, a bank of 393 images from 131 individuals were created, and they were used subsequently for this study. The photographic standards were done such that 0 equals no photo damage and 8 equals severe atrophic facial photo damage, thus making a 9-point scale. A further 20 photographs were then selected to test the scale, spanning across the entire range of values. 3 groups were then asked to test the photonumeric scale, and these consisted of 10 dermatologists, 10 non-dermatology clinicians and 14 dermatology scientists. They tested the photonumeric scale against a descriptive equivalent. They were then asked to retest the photonumeric and descriptive scales a week later, and the order of those photographs were randomised to avoid any bias. We found that there was a significantly greater agreement between the graders using the photonumeric scale as compared to the descriptive scale, with no significant difference in repeatability between the two methods, with a p of less than 0.05. We feel that this is hugely important to dermatologists, firstly because it's a newly described phenotype that many dermatologists may have seen in practice, but it's never been outlined in the literature. Secondly, this phenotype appears to have a much higher predilection for the development of keratinocytic skin cancers. Therefore, it's extremely important to have an easy to use tool such that not just dermatologists, but also non-dermatology clinicians alike can easily recognise atrophic individuals, which will positively impact on their clinical care in the long run.